In this video, I will teach you how to find rate analysis for 2.5 cm thick cement concrete 1:2:4 floor with neat cement finishing at top. Let us consider an area of 100 meter square. Now we have to do the material calculation. To find the volume of concrete for an area of 100 meter square, the volume will be found out by multiplying area with the thickness. Here the area is the assumed area, which is 100 meter square, and thickness is the thickness of the floor, which is of 2.5 centimeter in this question. Now you have to convert that centimeter in terms of meter, for which we have to divide our value with 100. So on simplifying this, we will get a value of 2.5 meter cube. That gives you the volume of the concrete for area of 100 meter square. Then for the same volume, we have to add 10% extra for the uneven surface of the base concrete. So for the same area, extra 10% we have to add. That means 2.5 will remain as it is, and extra 2.5 of 10% we have to find. For that, the calculation look like this. 2.5 will be as it is plus 10% of this. That means 2.5 into 10 divided by 100 we have to do. Then on simplifying the whole thing, we will get a value of 2.75 meter cube. So this gives you the new volume of the concrete, including the unevenness of the bed. Then now for the new volume, we again have to add 50% extra for the dry volume. So this is the volume of the wet concrete. For finding the dry volume, we have to add 50% more for this. That means 2.75 will remain as it is plus extra 50% of this. Again, we had to take the same value, that is 2.75 into 50/100. So this gives you the 50% extra, and this gives you the value of the volume what we have considered earlier. Now on adding these two things, we will get a volume of 4.125 meter cube, which represents the volume of the wet concrete. Which represents the volume of the dry concrete. Now for the dry concrete volume, we have to find the materials quantity. Let us start finding the quantity of materials. So we know that the concrete consists of three materials. One is the cement, other is the sand, and then coarse aggregate. So let us start finding the quantities of all those three materials one by one. Starting with the cement, we had to take the volume of the dry concrete, which is 4.125, that divided by sum of the proportion. In this problem, the proportion which is given to us is 1:2:4. Hence, we had to add the proportion here, 1 + 2 + 4, into the part of the cement. Here, 1 represents the part of the cement. Hence, we had to multiply this value with 1. And then finally, we had to simplify the whole thing. On simplifying, we will get a value of 0.59 meter cube. But we always take cement in terms of number of bags. Hence, you convert this meter cube in terms of bags, for which you have to multiply your value with 30. On multiplying the value with 30, we will get the number of bags as 17.7, approximately take 18 number of bags. So totally the quantity of cement should be of 18 bags. Then finding out the next quantity, that is sand. Again, we had to take the dry volume of concrete, which is 4.125, divided by sum of the proportion, 1 + 2 + 4, into the part of the sand. Here 2 represents the part of the sand. Hence we need to multiply the value with 2. Then on simplifying the whole thing, we will get a value of 1.178, approximately take the value as 1.18 meter cube. Moving to the next quantity, that is coarse aggregate. Again, we have to take the dry volume of concrete, that is 4.125, divided by sum of the proportion, that is 1 + 2 + 4, into the part of the concrete. Here 4 represents the part of the coarse aggregate. That hence you multiply this with 4. Simplify the whole thing, we will get a value of 2.357, approximately take the value as 2.36 meter cube. So this gives you the quantities of all the materials. But in the question, it is said that we have to include the cement finishing at the top. So if this sentence is mentioned in the question, at that time extra cement will be applied. So that extra cement will be of 6 bags. So the total, the earlier we have, the quantity, while finding the quantity of the material, we have got 18 number of bags of cement for the proportion 1:2:4 for a thickness of floor of 2.5 centimeter. But if we include the finishing also, we had to add extra 6 number of bags. After adding 6 bags with the 18 bags, the total quantity of cement will become 24 bags. So this gives you the final quantity of cement for the proportion 1:2:4 for the thickness of concrete flooring of 2.5 centimeter including cement finishing at the top. So that completes the material calculation. If it won't ask you to find the finishing or if they won't ask you to include the finishing, then at that time we can take the quantity of cement as 18 itself. Only if it is mentioned in the question, by that time only we had to add extra number of bags of cement. Otherwise, whatever the quantity which we have got from the calculation, that itself we can keep. Now, after finding all the material calculation, let us draw the table. The table should consist of serial number, particulars, quantity, rate as well as amount. So, whatever the quantities of material that we have found earlier, everything we need to write in this table. Coming to the first part, the material part, we are having three types of materials here. One is the cement, other is the sand, and then the coarse aggregate. Whatever the coarse aggregate which we are using for the flooring, that will be of 20 mm downsized stones. So now, here, whatever the quantities that we have found in the earlier step, the same quantities we need to copy in this table. We have got 24 number of bags of cement and 1.18 meter cube of sand and 2.36 meter cube of coarse aggregate. Then, whatever the rate which is fixed nowadays, that rate we had to write here according to the unit. The rate for the cement is 330 per bag, for sand is 1300 per meter cube, for coarse aggregate it is 700 per meter cube. Now, for finding the amount for all the materials, we had to multiply the quantity with the given rate. So on multiplying 24 with 330, you will get 7920 rupees. On multiplying 1.18 with 1300, you will get 1534 rupees. Similarly, on multiplying 2.36 with 700, you will get 1652 rupees. So all this gives you the amount for the materials. So likewise, we had to write the number of labors which are required for the cement concrete flooring of 2.5 centimeter thickness. Here, though totally it requires three types of labors. One is the head mason, other is the mason, and then the mazdoor. See, in the mazdoor itself, we are adding two number of bishtis. Bishtis means waterman. So after finishing the flooring, it requires curing. So whatever the water which is applied by the person, so the person is named as the bishti here. So including bishti, the number of mazdoors are 12 and a half numbers. The number of masons which are required are 10 and a half numbers and the head mason is half number. That means half a day head mason will visit the site and totally there are 10 number of person which will be doing work in a whole day, but only half person will do half a day. Only one person will do the work half a day. And then similarly for the mazdoor, this is given as 12 and half. That means 12 people will do the work whole day. Only one people will do the work half a day. That is why I have written this as 12 and half numbers. Now, whatever the rate which are fixed for all the types of the labors that has been written here. And then for finding the amount, we had to multiply the quantity with the rate. So on multiplying half with 400, you get 200. Then 10 in the place of 10 and half, you had to take this as 10.5. So 10.5 into 390 gives you 4095. Similarly, in the place of 2 and half, you had to take 12.5. So 12.5 into 290 gives you 3625 rupees. So this comes the amount for the labors. Then moving to the contingency part, for the contingency or the extra charges for as well as the transportation charges, we will be assuming a lump sum amount of 80 rupees. So that completes the rate analysis part. Now to find the total amount, we had to add all the amounts of all the three types, that is material amount with the labor amount with the contingency. On adding all these things, we will get a final amount of 19,106 rupees. So now for this amount, we will be adding 1% of water charges. So for which you had to find 1% of this, for which you had to multiply the value into 1 with and then divide that with 100. So by doing that, you will get 191 rupees 6 paise. Then by adding these two amounts, you will get a new total amount of 19,297 rupees 6 paise. Now for the new amount, we will be adding the 10% of the profit and the overhead charges. So let us find the 10% of this. To find 10% of this, we have to multiply this value with 100 and divide that with 100. Sorry, we have to multiply the value with 10 and divide that with 100. On doing that, we will get the amount of 1,929 rupees and 70 paise. Then by adding these two amounts, we will get a grand total amount or the final amount of 21,226 rupees and 76 paise. Then this grand total amount represents the final amount for the cement concrete flooring of a thickness of 2.5 centimeter, including the cement smooth finishing for an area of 100 meter square. So the amount is for 100 meter square of area. Similarly, if we want to find the amount for 1 meter square of area, then what will be the amount? So for finding that, rate per square meter will be found out by dividing the grand total amount with 100. On dividing 21,226.766 with 100, we will get a value of 212.267. Approximately take the value as 212 rupees. That means if you want to do the cement concrete flooring for 1 meter square of area, it will cost 212 rupees. So this completes the rate analysis for the cement concrete flooring for the 2.5 centimeter thick, including the smooth finish.